Welcome back to Cypher, the show that takes caregiving stories and turns them into songs. In this episode, we collaborate with Junior T, Jarrell the Young, and...
Me!
Junior was recently shortlisted for this year's Polaris Music Prize, and he's Jesse Reyes' tour DJ.
And Jarrell is a multi-platinum producer who's worked with Fall Out Boy, David Guetta, and he's just dropped a solo project.
So let's check it out.
Ready?
Dying is hard to talk about. But as caregivers, we need to have these conversations. And our friend Rami thought we could learn from a past client that he referred to as Alka.
How does it go?
Bring it back to the top.
Alka is a pharmacist assistant. She had trained overseas, came here, and had to overcome a lot of racism.
Rami's assigned to try and help Alka, who's working full-time, running her household, and trying to help her dad. She's drowning.
To surrender his care to someone else doesn't fit her cultural values.
That's just not how they do things.
She couldn't do it.
Nah, bro.
So what about us?
My mom was also a caregiver.
My dad, he was in palliative care.
I've had a number of family members pass away.
Mental health challenges have come and gone throughout my entire career.
Each of us relate to this story in unique ways. But bottom line, we all relate to it.
So many ways to say the same message.
Watching my hero fall apart while my babies grow. Weight of the world on my shoulders trying to break me slow.
Maybe pitch down.
I'm with that.
She says, I'm feeling really sad, but at the same time angry.
It just feels so deeply unfair.
Death does not always come quickly.
She said, I feel he's died before he's died.
You're almost like paralyzed.
Am I going crazy?
You're so underprepared for that actual goodbye. It's exhausting.
And I'm losing the time, losing my prime. When you get used to this life, who wouldn't cry? I'm losing my mind.
And I say, no, Alka, you're not going crazy. You're a caregiver that's burnt out. And the anticipation of death can create feelings before he's died.
I never really thought that you could grieve before someone died.
And that's like a lot of energy to give.
I'm learning so much.
Aspects of mental health start to creep in, right? Depression, anxiety, low sex drive. Sleeplessness.
Something's never changed when emotions need expressing. Trust is to be gained.
That's right.
It's hard to be the strong one every day. Words can't express the love underneath the pain.
Leading up to his death, the potency of her emotion became stronger and stronger.
Is this the moment we've been dreading?
And I said, Alka, Raj asked me a very challenging question.
This is the moment we've been waiting for.
Is this what it feels like to die?
The curtain falls and all the lights come on in the hall. Oh, we loved it and now it's over. Raise the glass and have a toast up. Walking, laughing round this field. Loving, losing, now we're here. What a beautiful day to die. What a beautiful way to say goodbye.
Damn.
And she broke down. And she was in full anticipatory grief. But there was a moment, she talked, a moment of stillness, where it was just him and her. His breath slowed down. He died in her arms. And then she just held him.
No more pain, no more sorrow. No more moments to exchange. Feel these feelings throughout me. Tomorrow won't be the same. No more pain, no more sorrow. No more moments to explain. Though I feel you around me, I won't forget, no regrets. So goodbye till we meet again.
When I saw Alka, there wasn't much tears. She said, you know, because I had the chance to feel my feelings around me. At the end, the grief wasn't as complicated or as harbored.
Today, we share some deeply personal feelings about caregiving for someone who's dying.
Good grief, it's the good grief.
And we came out the other side stronger.
It actually changed the entire song.
Yeah, that's it.
Can you sing it again, if you don't mind?
Yeah.
So goodbye till we meet again. So goodbye till we meet again.
Nobody presents it like this. This can help break down the barriers.